Report package distribution provides the ability to securely distribute report content to stakeholders via multiple distribution cycles, distribute entire reports or subsets of reports, vary report content by recipient, view reports online or download locally via native or PDF files, and distribute reports at any time during the report development cycle. Let's begin by opening a report package. Select the Distribution tab in the left panel. As a report package owner, I have access to the Manager and Access tabs because I am responsible for building the distribution and assigning access to users. Recipients of a distribution only have access to this Viewer tab. Viewers cannot do anything with a distributed report other than view or download the report. Let's add a distribution. Enter a name and an optional description. In the rollover count field, enter the number of distribution executions that will persist in the system. In this example, we limit the number of distribution executions to the last 5 weeks. Enter a notification subject and message to provide context for the recipients. These will appear as the subject line and message in the notification email that is sent when you execute the distribution. Select the targets available to the recipients. Recipients can view the distribution in the report package browser, download the distribution, or download as a PDF file. Assign users and groups that you want to participate in the distribution and save the distribution. Now let's look at controlling access for the distribution. You set access by report package, not by distribution. This means you cannot vary a user's access between different distributions. You can select Full to grant all recipients view access to the entire report. Alternatively, you can select Limited to restrict the recipient's view access to defined areas of the report. Under Full Access, you can add users who you want to have full access to the entire report. Under Limited Access, you can define an access filter to control access to specific areas of the report. Provide a name for the access filter, and then assign users or groups to the access filter. First, I'll set up an Allow filter to define areas of the report where I want to allow access. Notice that I can filter by attributes or report package structure. I'll select Report Package Structure, and then select the report package areas where I want to allow access. In this example, I select the Finance section and click OK. I'll set up a secondary filter by attribute. In the Add Filter Item dialog, in the Filter On field, you have the option to select Docklet, Section or Docklet. I'll select Docklet, select Name in the Attribute field, set the operator to Contains, add a search text, and click OK. When you execute the distribution, users assigned to the access filter will get all the content in the finance section of the report and any docklets with a name that contains units. Now, let's set up a restrict filter, which will restrict access to an area of the report where we allowed access. Note, you are adding another condition within the same filter. It is limited to only the area of the report that you defined in the Allow filter, the Finance section in this example. I'll set up a filter by attributes that excludes any docklets that contain the word Notes. Save the distribution. When you are done, execute the distribution. The assigned users receive a notification via email where they can drill to the target links. Users also receive a message in the browser UI. I'll scroll to confirm that the access filters have been applied as expected. Use the selector to access prior executions of a distribution. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.